हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सौरभ पटवर्धन फ्रॉम नंदा दीपाय हॉस्पिटल फेको SICS ट्रेनिंग सेंटर सांगली महाराष्ट्र इंडिया. एंड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैड शोन 3 केसेस ऑफ पोस्टियर सब कैप्सुलर कैटरैक्ट और PPC. एंड आई वॉन्टेड टू आस्क यू विच ऑफ दीज यू फील इज़ अ PPC एंड हाउ विल यू गो अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर केस. सो दिस इज द केस 1. Fuzzy margins, no well demarcated areas in the posterior opacity. So I feel this is the posterior subcapsular cataract, a classical one, and I need not take any precautions like in posterior polar cataract. Now case 2 looks like a posterior subcapsular cataract. There are few areas where the margins are more demarcated, but I assume that this is a posterior subcapsular cataract. Again, I take no specific precautions like posterior polar, and the surgery went uneventful. Removed the cortex. I was not taking any special precautions here, and when I was about to inject the viscoelastic, the posterior capsule opened up. I'm not sure whether it was weak posterior capsule or it was the touch by the visco cannula. But in most cases, the touch of the visco cannula should not open the posterior capsule. So I may assume that there was some weakness of the posterior capsule. I converted it into posterior CCC and managed the case well. Now, third case, there are a few signs of posterior polar cataract. As you can see, there are sharper margins, though there is a component where there are fuzzy margins, but I presumed this as a posterior polar cataract, thus avoided the hydrodissection, did all the steps which are classically described for the posterior polar cataract. It went uneventful, so no issues as such. I placed in the bag. So I presumed that the third case was the posterior polar cataract, though there was a PC opening in the second case, which probably was because of some manual error. But let's think over this case. Apart from these three, looks more like the second case, more demarcated, sharply demarcated areas, but not very classical posterior polar cataract. And here is the surgeon operating. Something was different when we reviewed the video here, and you can see the fluid going behind the posterior epinucleus, and there was some fluid which was going away from it into the vitreous. The surgeon did another hydrodissection, and you can now classically see the posterior capsular blowout, and here it is in the slow motion. You can see the posterior capsule opened up here right in the center in the area of opacity, and you could see the flow going into the vitreous. Now it could be because of fluid buildup or small CCC, or it could be because of the weakened posterior capsule. Now we have to take the surgeon's word for it that he had not pushed the fluid too strongly, so it was like the usual hydrodissection wave which he had attempted. The surgeon is experienced enough to understand that there was no fluid buildup in the space behind the posterior epinucleus. So here I presume that there was a posterior capsule weakness here. It opened up during hydrodissection, and now what we are going to see is the classical posterior ledge sign which I have described. And you can see this is the posterior capsule and the posterior cortical matter which is seen like a ledge, and now the nucleus is actually, there is an impending nucleus drop. It is going to go downwards now. It's going to go posterior unless surgeon stops. The ledge sign is not picked up by the surgeon, and that's why you can see the nucleus slowly tilting and going into the vitreous. So definitely here there was a posterior capsular opening during the hydrodissection. So if you see the cases, when you see under the surgical microscope, we see fuzzy margins, no areas of sharp demarcation in a classical posterior subcapsular cataract. But whenever there is area of sharp demarcation, and then there might be a more likelihood that posterior capsule may be weak in that area, though of course many cases go uneventful. Now this is a classical posterior polar. A plaque with defined margin present since young age, and there is a sink classification where opacity associated with PSC or opacity with ring onion-like appearance, onion peel appearance, opacity with dense white spots at the edge, we also call it Dalgic sink sign, and that it can be associated with nucleus crosses. So there are cases which are definitely posterior polar where we have to take care, but there are these cases which are much more in number where it's a posterior subcapsular cataract, but we are always doubtful whether it has posterior capsular weakness associated or not. So if you look for carefully for that sharp demarcated margins, which can be seen even under the surgical microscope, or you can look for it in the OPD by focusing on this posterior capsular opacity, and whenever you feel that there are some areas in the opacity which are sharply demarcated, I will treat it as a presumed posterior polar cataract. Of course, it takes longer time for the surgery because you are taking more precautions, but it's best to avoid complications rather than managing them once it happens. So this is my thought process. You can have your own thought process. Do write to me, do write on the comments, do subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much.